The sun rises over the camp and towers of Harrenhal. Liana is one of the first to wake as she hears the birds singing outside. As she walks around the castle, hundreds of people are already preparing the arena made for the joust. She even spots her betrothed, Robert, training with a big sword himself while several squires attend him. Liana herself quietly walks off towards a secluded area in the nearby forest. She has a sword of her own, which she uses while slashing at a tree. Since she can't participate in the tourney, she reckons this could give her some enjoyment as well. She spends her time well enough, until suddenly, someone appears behind her. Rhaegar. Liana is startled and doesn't know what to say, but Rhaegar smiles and wishes her no disruption. He just found it queer to see a noble lady off in the woods alone, with a sword. Liana claims she isn't just a lady. She's a Stark. She's born a fighter, a wolf. They have a pleasant conversation in which Rhaegar mentions he will actually participate. He asks after Robert and what kind of man he is, to which Liana answers positively, like she should. The prince even asks her to show him some moves with her sword, which she also does eventually. They spend some time together as Liana swings her sword around and Rhaegar looks and gives her some tips and tricks he knows himself. They end up losing track of time when suddenly they both hear the horns and trumpets sounding from Harrenhal. They both look at each other, knowing what that means. The tourney is about to begin. Eddard and Benjen are at the jousting arena when Brandon arrives in his shining armor. The two wish their big brother the best of luck. He must show all those other lords what kind of powerhouse Stark truly shows. Brandon laughs, fully being confident in himself. When their father Rickard shows up alongside with Jon Arryn, they have a whole motivating conversation. A nice father-son moment where Rickard expresses his pride in him. Slightly late, Liana also arrives and wishes her brother good fortune. The trumpets sound again as everyone has to take their places. The tribunes are all filled with all the noble lords who are present. It's Lord Wendt who announces the first match of jousting to be held. Lord Brandon Stark against the Knight of House Frey. Everyone cheers and applauds, especially the Stark siblings for their brother. The two participants arrive on their horses and go to their positions. All the way in the middle of the huge tribune, the king sits in silence, watching over the whole arena. He's surrounded on all sides by Kingsguard men, and still he feels haunted. Mainly because his son Rhaegar isn't present. Ilya Martell is, but Aerys won't say a word to her. The grand words are set, the trumpets sound, the cheering roars, and the two participants ride straight towards each other. Both smack their lances at each other, but manage to remain on their horses. It's during the second round that Brandon manages to unhorse his opponent. A lot of people stand up and cheer for the wolf, especially Liana, Benjen, and Eddard. Brandon is officially called the winner of the first match. Later that day, Robert prepares himself for his melee match. Liana is with him for encouragement. Robert does appreciate it, but he's completely taken over by his drive to win. He even starts to get annoyed by several squires who try to fix his armor, but they are far too slow in his opinion. Liana smiles and wishes him good luck. That makes Robert smile as well. There's clear love in his eyes. He again promises her to make his queen by the tourney's end. His queen of love and beauty. The day passes by as several more matches of jousting and melee are held. Ilya Martell and Rhaegar Targaryen both walk through the castle halls and talk to each other. Rhaegar tells her the history of this castle, how it was once destroyed by the dragons of Aegon. Ilya is infatuated by his stories, yet she does seem quiet. It's now revealed that they actually sent their daughter back to Dragonstone with their servants, but Ilya doesn't know if she can trust that. Rhaegar understands but assures her that it's all right. She will be perfectly safe. As they walk, the prince looks outside again at all the hundreds of people. He again spots the wolf girl, Liana, and continues to stare at her. Ilya doesn't notice this and asks if he's nervous for the tourney. Rhaegar only shakes his head. Eventually, Ilya claims to be tired again and asks leave to go to her tent. Rhaegar lets her go alone as he returns to the people. Ilya walks through the halls and camp straight to her tent. As she enters, she suddenly sees someone else inside. She's startled and demands to know who it is. As the figure turns around, it's revealed to be Oberyn Martell. Ilya gasps, and the two embrace each other. Oberyn laughs, mentioning he wanted to surprise his sister, although it was a pain to find her place among all these people. Oberyn also claims to join the tourney. He's curious to see what kind of a fighter Rhaegar truly is. Ilya smiles and asks all sorts of questions about home, about their family. The two have a nice moment together. During another jousting match, Arthur Dayne manages to unhorse another knight. Eddard and Benjen look at the Kingsguard. Benjen mentions how Sir Dayne is one of the greatest fighters the world has ever seen, and it shows. Eddard nods and simply observes the man from a distance. It's hard enough to understand each other with all those people talking and cheering so loudly. Howland Reed is alone in his tent while he's also trying to practice with his own sword. He clearly isn't as talented as all the others. He almost feels stupid for even being here, but it's required of him, being a lord. As he swings his sword, he suddenly notices the three squires again who beat him the other day. Howland quickly hides behind his tent. He doesn't want to be seen again by those three. Suddenly, he turns around and almost shrieks when Lyanna stands in front of him. She laughs and asks what he's doing. Howland tries to act natural, but clearly isn't feeling at ease. Lyanna soon sees that it's because of those squires again. She urges Howland to stand up for himself. He claims he wants, even thought about challenging them in the tourney, but it's no use, since he'd probably make a fool out of himself. Lyanna shakes her head. What kind of a lord always doubts himself? Howland is simply frustrated, wanting vengeance and honoring himself and his people on one hand, but being afraid of a shameful fight on the other. Lyanna feels sympathy for the young lord and again offers to join her and her family this night at the feast. Howland accepts gladly. Robert is fully ready at the arena for the melee. The stag arrives in his shining armor with antlers on his helmet, his sword and shield ready. Everyone cheers for him as his opponent, a random other knight, also arrives. Lord Wendt announces the two of them for everyone. Robert raises his arms and cheers loudly himself. He looks around and sees his Stark friends also supporting him. Lyanna is there as well, smiling at him. This gives him all the courage he needs. Everything goes silent as they all look at the king. Aerys, again sitting in silence and surrounded by his guards, he eventually claps his hands, and thus the melee begins. Robert and his opponent have a good fight as everyone cheers and shouts. It doesn't take too long before the stag smacks the other two down to the ground, and the yield soon follows. Robert wins and they all cheer, himself included. Lyanna smiles and claps, yet it's more out of formality than something else. That night, the second great feast is held. Many people are dancing as a band plays cheerful music. Robert eats and drinks, considering himself already being the champion. Aerys sits at the main table, Rhaegar and Ilya again right beside him. Lyanna sits next to Robert as he talks with Eddard and Brandon. Howland Reed also joins them, being welcomed once again. He feels slightly awkward, but the Stark siblings do a good job of making him join the conversation. They all talk about who is probably going to be the champion at the end, all of them having different opinions. Lyanna supports Robert, of course, yet deep down she's thinking someone else who might win. Suddenly, Howland turns cold again. Lyanna notices and asks what's the matter. The Kranic man mentions how he sees those same three squires again. This time, Benjen, Eddard, and Brandon also take part of the conversation. As Lyanna explains what happened, Benjen believes Howland should indeed fight for the honor of his house. It's the right thing to do. Brandon and Eddard agree. Howland claims he wants to, but doesn't know how. Benjen offers to bring him a horse and armor so Howland can settle it in a jousting match, but the offer is turned down. Howland is simply too unsure of himself. The conversation ends as Howland walks away, yet Lyanna keeps on looking at the three squires. She tries to see which houses they belong to, and she eventually also gets up and follows Howland outside. The feast continues. Oberyn asks Ilya to dance with him, which she does. They both smile and laugh while Aerys looks at them with dead eyes. The king eventually orders wine. When this is accidentally spilled, he starts to smack the servant and curse so loudly that the entire hall hears him. Rhaegar intervenes, however, and manages to calm everyone down. His father is disgusted and walks away before his son can say anything to him. The atmosphere has partly vanished due to this outburst, but the music does continue. Outside, Liana finds Howland as she asks him to return to them. Howland refuses, finding it very kind of her, but he just isn't who he needs to be, and he hates it. As the young lord confesses his frustrations, Eddard also joins them. Out of compassion, Ned proposes Howland to come and stay at his tent for the night, as a sign that even the lord of House Reed has friends here. Howland finds that very kind and eventually accepts. Eddard smiles and guides him to his tent where they have a nice time. Later that night, Howland goes to a nearby forest where he prays to the old gods. He prays for strength, for honor, and for vengeance. With all his heart, he does. That same night, Liana also grabs another sword and decides to head back to the forest to the same open space where she was last morning. She sees Howland praying from a distance, feeling much empathy for him, wanting to help him. She eventually heads further and finds the open space again, only to find Rhaegar as well. The dragon prince smiles at her and mentions he was hoping to meet her again. Liana chuckles and claims she just wants some good practice. Rhaegar laughs and grabs a sword of his own, offering a duel between the two of them, just a friendly match. And there, under the bright moonlight, the two have a friendly duel as they talk and laugh together. In her tent, Ilya lies alone, thinking of Rhaegar, who isn't here yet, but most of all, thinking of her daughter, Rhaenys, how she just wants to hold her in her arms like a mother. The following days are those of great excitement and entertainment, jousting match after jousting match, melee after melee. Rhaegar unhorses Jon Royce in a joust, Robert defeats another knight in a melee match, Rhaegar wins from Arthur Dayne and Brandon Stark as well. Everyone cheers and applauds. Every day the tourney goes, every evening a feast is held. And every night, the dragon and the wolf share their friendly duel in the woods, without reason or motives, just because they find it pleasant. It all goes perfect until Robert faces Jon Royce in the final melee match. The fight is wild and thrilling until Robert gets smacked down to the ground. He tries to get up, but Jon keeps on bearing down on him with his sword. Eventually, Robert is forced to yield, and there goes his chance of becoming champion. The stag is sportive and congratulates Lord Royce of being a good opponent. Afterwards, Eddard meets him again and also says he did a fine match. Robert looks around but can't see Liana anywhere. If there's anyone who would like to see now, it's her. Eddard claims he doesn't know, but he guesses she will come eventually. As the next jousting match is prepared, the names of the next opponents are announced. Lord Wendt calls forth a knight of House Frey, and another knight, without a name. It appears a new name has been added to the list of contestants. Everyone, including King Aerys, finds this very queer. The Frey knight arrives on his horse, and so does the other. The knight has a rather small figure, dressed with mismatched armor. On his shield is shown a white weirwood tree with a laughing face. Aerys almost wants to cancel the joust because of the fact no one knows who this man is, but Lord Wendt and all the others claim it's exciting. Eventually the joust is allowed nonetheless. The Frey knight faces off with the knight without name. They ride at full speed towards each other with their lances, and the Frey knight instantly gets knocked off his horse. Everyone gasps. The mystery knight wins. As Lord Wendt wants to congratulate him, a loud booming voice comes out of the knight's helmet. The figure wishes to challenge two more knights. A knight of House Blount and one of House Hay. Upon hearing this, Howland Reed, who is also present, feels his eyes growing wide. The three squires that attacked him were, in fact, three squires of knights of Houses Frey, Blount and Hay. What could this be? What could this mean? After some discussing, the knight of House Blount agrees. He suits up and is ready to take on the mystery man himself. They again ride at full speed, and the knight of House Blount also gets knocked off his horse instantly. The gasps are even louder this time. Everyone looks around with huge eyes. Even Aerys starts to get uncomfortable. Sure enough, the knight of House Hay also accepts the challenge and loses as well. There stands the mystery knight, as he successfully unhorsed all three knights of the previous houses. Howland Reed is beyond words. His mouth is completely dropped, not believing what on earth he just saw. The three knights accept their defeat, yet want to know what the mystery knight's purpose was. The unknown figure looks at them and mentions how he has but one simple wish, that the three knights order their squires to be chastised due to their lack of honor and respect during the tourney. The three knights find it queer but agree either way. All the while, Howland still looks gobsmacked. Aris is losing his temper as he sees the mystery knight riding away. He turns around to his fellow guards and orders them to find the knight and bring him to him. He doesn't trust that man for one bit. Several guards all run into the direction where the knight was seen riding to, towards the forest. The guards try to find the figure, but all they find is the mystery knight's shield near a tree. All other traces are lost. As Aris hears this, he almost erupts out of anger. He won't have a stranger come at his tourney and sabotage everything. It could have been a traitor. Suddenly, the thought of Jaime Lannister goes through his head. The boy was so disappointed to be sent back to King's Landing. What if it was him? It must have been him. He walks around and around through the halls while his guards follow him. He eventually sighs and slams his fist against the wall, feeling betrayed once again. The tourney is almost over as everyone takes seats for the final match, the final joust between Rhaegar Targaryen and Barristan Selmy. As Robert is seated, Lyanna suddenly also joins him. He asks her where she was. She missed one hell of a joust. Lyanna chuckles, claiming she was busy somewhere else. Howland sits behind her and tells her everything, how this mystery knight came and fought the three knights of those squires, and they all lost. Howland has the biggest smile on his face, while Lyanna smiles back, feeling happy for him. Aerys is seated as well with Elia beside him. Oberyn sits beside his sister. All the Stark siblings sit together, everyone eagerly waiting for the final match. Rhaegar and Barristan arrive and are announced. The trumpets sound and the two ride at full force towards each other. Miss. They come around again. This time they both hit each other but remain balanced. The third time they come at full speed and Rhaegar unhorses Barristan Selmy. The Kingsguard falls down and everyone erupts in the air. Rhaegar is the final champion of the tourney. Elia has a big smile on her face, clapping her hands. Lyanna's smile is probably even brighter. Barristan crawls back up but also smiles at his prince, congratulating him. Lord Wendt rises and announces the prince as the official champion. Now, according to tradition, the champion can name one to be the next Queen of Love and Beauty. Everyone cheers and applauds as if the festivities just doubled in energy. Rhaegar smiles as his squire gives him a crown of blue winter roses. Rhaegar looks around and slowly rides his horse alongside the tribunes. Elia looks at him with a big smile, but that smile slowly fades as he rides past her and heads towards the Starks. There he stops and looks Lyanna directly in her eyes. Without saying anything, he lays the flowers in her lap. All that cheering that were there just a second ago, all of them have died out. As the Dragon Prince rides away, leaving Lyanna with the roses on her lap, the entire arena is dead silent. Elia is confused and doesn't know what to say as she stares at her husband with fragile eyes. Aerys looks bitter. Brandon looks like he's about to explode. Robert doesn't know what to think. And Lyanna is as quiet as a mouse. The prince rides away in silence, with only the sound of the wind to accompany him.